Hi, my name is Tom and you are at level 33 in Mastering Einstein's Special Relativity. We have covered all the theoretics up until level 32. Now it's time to look at the second best known example in special relativity. And that's the one where we have a huge rocket, we fly it through a very small shed, and because it's going so fast, we are able to catch it in the shed, close the doors, take the picture, open the doors, and let it continue its flight. This video has been done many times by different people. I added three levels of complexity, A, B, and C level, and I have added the real world perspective. And by doing so, I think this is a unique insight for this example, where we will actually see the different animations compared to each other. So, curious? Let's get into it. So the big rocket that will fit in a small shed when going fast. In level 28, we learned that big objects, when they go fast, they shrink. Classic length contraction. And that's from the point of view of someone not moving. From the point of view of the person who's moving, there's no difference. But from our point of view, stationary point of view, when we look in the sky, we see that that thing is smaller than when it's sitting next to us in a stationary mode. That's what I said. But then, if you would actually videotape it, then we see whole other things happening. We will see that when the object is approaching us, it looks bigger on the videotape. It appears to go much faster on the videotape than it actually is, and it appears to be further away than it actually is. This is really strange. And once the object is flying past us and is moving away, then we will see that it's smaller and it's slower and it's closer. This has all been discussed about in the previous level, level 32. But these are the things we are now going to apply to this big rocket flying through a small shed. So let's do the experiment, right? In this case, the rocket is 25 meters. He's flying at 80% of the speed of light. And the shed through which it will fly in and out of is 20 meters. What will happen from the farmer's perspective? That's the one in the shed, the one taking the picture of the rocket once it is in the shed. These are the true events, the ones that will not be on the videotape, but are the events that will actually happen. Here we have the animation. On the right, you see the beginning of the shed. Its doors are opened, and we see this rocket. And once I hit play, and you know, it will start moving, but we see a rocket of 15 meters, because 15 meters is the contraction. Because it's flying at 8% of the speed of light, 25 meters will have contracted into 15 meters. And then it will fit a 20 meter shed, right? Let's see. This is the clock for the farmer. It starts at minus 40 seconds when he starts taping it. And I'm not sure how long it will run, but we'll see. So here it is. This is the rocket flying at 80% of the speed of light. It enters the shed. Because of length contraction, it will actually fit. Doors can close, take the picture, open the doors, and it can move out. This is really possible. Although when the rocket is at rest, it will be 25 meters long. But due to length contraction, when it's moving so fast, it will be 15 meters. And 15 is less than 20. So it will fit the 20 meter shed. This is true. I know it's hard to believe, but this is true. So then the farmer said, I'm going to videotape this stuff. Here is the movie that he took. First off, before I start the animation, you see that the rocket is stretched. That's one of the things we discovered in the previous level, that moving objects appear to be much larger and moving much faster than they actually are. So I ignored some of the three-dimensional effects for the professionals watching. So we will not do the rotational stuff here. We will only look at what happens in the direction of motion. The yellow things give us the tip and the back of the rocket. So here it is. Again, minus 40 seconds, he starts videotaping. And it's much faster. It's coming at us now at 4 times the speed of light, if you would do the actual numbers. And what happens when it meets the shed? Well, here's the shed. And then as soon as it hits the middle of the shed, it starts moving slower. Much, much slower. Close the doors. Take the picture. Open the doors, and off we go. And we see a much smaller rocket leaving the shed, not 15 meters, not even the contracted length, but even smaller than 15. I think it's 8.444 if we would do the numbers. So this is the videotape, which, you know, if you would believe your eyes, the video, you would have completely different conclusions than what actually happened, which was the first animation. But now we are going to take things to the next level. We are going to look from the rocket's perspective. First off, what really happens when you are inside the rocket? You don't think you're moving at all. You're just stationary. You're 25 meters long and there's a shed coming at you and doors are opening and closing. Let's see what happens. So here's the rocket, it's stationary, because we are the rocket now, and this shed is coming at us at 80% of the speed of light. And because of that, the shed of 20 meters is now way smaller due to length contraction. So we see a smaller shed. And let's do invert the clock here. The rocket pilot also starts at taping at minus 40 seconds. And this is what happens. He sees the shed coming at him or her. And it will never fit, right? This will never fit. No, but now the door closes and opens the right door. And what about the left door? The left door closes now and opens again. So not only length contraction kicked in, but we lost simultaneity. So from the farmer's perspective, the doors were closed and opened at the same time. But from the rocket's perspective, that was not the case at all. First, the right door closed, and a little bit later, the left door closed. This is what really happens from the rocket's perspective. I know it's difficult to comprehend, but this is special relativity for you. It's really happening. So the rocket pilot wants to film this. So he takes his camera as well, but he doesn't film the truth. No, he will film something else. Because we said moving objects coming at you will appear on videotape much bigger. So he doesn't see a very tiny shed. He sees an incredibly stretched shed. And it will not come at him at 80% of the speed of light, but 4 times the speed of light. Here it comes. Again, it goes a lot faster than the previous animation. And there it goes. And what happens? Look at the door. As soon as it hits the green line, it starts to slow down. All the way from 4 times the speed of light to 0.44. And there goes the door. And now the other stuff. And now the left door will close and open. Boom, boom. Yeah, close. And open again, please. There it opens. And the shed now even looks smaller than it is. It's not even the length contraction, but the real world, the video camera effect also makes it look a little bit more smaller. So, this blows your mind, right? Let's see them all 4 together. So, here you see on the left hand, what actually happens from the perspective of the farmer and what actually happens from the perspective of the rocket. And these both realities are both true. I know it's really difficult to accept, but these are the realities. And then they both videotape it and they see something completely different than reality. The clocks of the farmer in both animations are the same. The clocks for the rocket are in both animations the same. But, you know, I will run the animations from minus 40 seconds on each clock. But do remember that the farmer's clock and the rocket clock are not synced. They are not even spinning at the same speed. Eh? And if you want to know why, check out level 27, time dilation. But for now, I made the animations run start from minus 40. So you cannot compare up and down. You can compare left and right. So here we go. Four different realities. I've watched this like, well, not a million times, but at least 10, 20 times, something like that. And it's so weird. It's so incredibly weird. And you see that the timestamps when doors are opening and closing on the video are completely different than the timestamps of reality. Simultaneity is lost. Stretching and shrinking is going on. It is really, really difficult. And this all happens. And imagine you would be the rocket pilot and someone else would be the farmer and you would compare your videos. That would be an interesting conversation. In fact, I think that the next slide is on that topic. Yes. So the astronaut is the female on the left and the farmer is the guy on the right. And as you can tell by their body language, they are not happy with each other after exchanging videotapes. In fact, hearts are broken. Even the famous Dutch stroopwafel, which is a cookie, here in the heart is a stroopwafel, will not be able to glue the heart together. It's lost forever. And these are the numbers. In the sea level, we will actually do the calculations, but here you see the truth from the farmer's perspective, the truth from the rocket's perspective, but also what they see on video for how big is the shed, how fast is the shed going, how big are the doors, how big is the rocket, how fast is the rocket, when does the left door close and open, when does the right door close and open. And you see, just by looking at the numbers, it is all over the place. So it's really, really difficult to compare and understand these differences if you wouldn't be Einstein and invented special relativity. This is it, the A level. In the B level, we go a little bit more deep, but I made many other videos, of course, leading up to this example. Here you see level one from the ground up. Another one, you can pause the video and see if there's anything you like. We are now all the way down to level 33A, doing the big rocket in the small shed. And in the next one, we will use the space-time diagram online, and you can use it as well. I'm not only going to show you, but you can go there and do it yourself. So I hope you have enjoyed these four animations. It took me numerous hours to create them and make sure that I did it right, because it's so easy to make mistakes in special relativity. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you at the next level.